Hello everyone and welcome to another AdMaths tutorial video. Now I'll be discussing Form 5 Additional Mathematics, Chapter 4 Vectors, Long Question Example 2. Before that, if you are new to this channel and first time watching my video, consider yourself subscribing to the channel and hit the bell icon for more upcoming mathematics tutorial videos in the future. Alright guys, without further delay, let's jump to the question now. As you are looking right now is Chapter 4 Vectors, Long Question, Example 2. Okay, let's read the question together. In the diagram, OS is equals to 1 over 4 OQ, PQ is parallel to OR, and PQ is equals to 3 over 4 of OR. So as you can see here, this diagram is in the form of trapezium, which combination of three triangles over here. So as you can see here, this one big triangle, and one medium-sized triangle and one small triangle over here. So these three chunk of triangle form together to form a big trapezium. So continue to read the question. Given that vector OP is equals to 8P and OQ is equals to 12Q, which means vector OQ is equals to 12Q, express each of the following vectors in terms of component P and component Q. So we have given a three questions. So the question asks us to find vector OR, vector PS and vector QR in terms of P and Q. So once all done, we still have one question left. Hence prove that PS is parallel to QR, which is vector PS is parallel to QR, vector QR. Alright guys, I hope you will attempt this question in the future. If you could manage to solve this question, well done guys, but if you can't solve this question, no worries. I'm going to show you the step-by-step working and the solutions now. Okay, let's proceed to the solutions now. Okay, for the first step is we are going to find the vector PQ. In order to find the vector OR, for the first step, we need to find the vector PQ. So how to find the vector PQ? So vector PQ is equals to vector PO plus vector OQ. In the question, they only give us the vector OP, which is equals to 8P. So how to find vector PO is very simple, guys. Vector PO is the opposite direction of vector OP. So in this case, our vector PO will be negative 8P. Okay. For the vector OQ over here, is the given in the question is 12Q. So vector OQ is equals to 12Q. So vector PO is negative 8P, vector OQ is 12Q. So when you add them together, so we'll get your answer, negative 8P plus 12Q. So as you look at the right hand side over here, this is the triangular diagram guys of the vector triangle method. So vector, in order to find vector PQ, you have to add vector PO plus vector OQ. So to show that these vectors are in a continuous form. So once you already find the vector PQ, so the next step is we can proceed to find vector OR. Okay, in the question, so if you notice or not, okay, they've already give us the relation that vector PQ is equals to 3 over 4 of vector OR. So we're going to use this relation to find our vector OR, guys. Okay. So 3 over 4 OR is equals to vector PQ. So vector PQ we already find, which is negative 8P plus 12Q. So we're going to substitute in here. So 3 over 4 vector OR is equals to negative 8P plus 12Q. So to find vector OR, it's very simple. We times with 4 and then divide with 3. So to find it, so we times the 4 first. So we get 3 OR is equals to negative 32P plus 48Q. So to find vector OR, you divide the whole equation by 3. So from here, you get your answer. Negative 32 over 3P plus 16Q. So this will be your answer, guys, of vector OR. So let us proceed to find vector PS now. So it's in the next page. So please hold on for a moment. Okay, Before finding vector PS, the first step we need to do is we need to find the vector of OS. So how to find the vector of OS, I'm going to show you now. In the question, they've already gave us the relationship is vector OS is equals to 1 over 4 of vector OQ, guys. So vector OQ is given as 12Q. So vector OS is equals to 1 over 4 of 12Q. So 1 over 4 times 12Q, you should get your answer is 3Q, guys. So this is your first answer. I mean, vector OS is equals to 3Q. So once you already proceed to find the OS, so once you already get the answer of OS, so we can proceed to find the vector PS. Okay, how to find the vector PS? So vector PS is equals to vector PO plus vector OS. So vector PO, so like I've mentioned, is in the opposite direction. So you need to add minus direction over here. So minus 8P. So OS we have already find here. So plus with 3Q. So this is your answer, guys. And in the right hand side, I've already showed you the triangle the triangle law. So to find PS is equals to PO you plus with OS. So to show that this vector are in continuous direction. So vector PS is equals to negative 8P plus 3Q. Alright guys, so we will already find the question B. So let us proceed to find our final question. Okay. So QR is equals to vector QO plus OR. So from here, vector QO we have already find, which is OQ, which is 12Q. So QO is the opposite direction of OQ, which is negative 12Q. Vector OR we have already find out in the earlier question, in the question A, which is negative 32 over 3P plus 16Q. Okay, close bracket. So when you add them up, you should get your answer negative 32 over 3P plus 4Q. So these are the diagram on the left hand side. I've actually drawn the diagram of the triangle law method, guys. So QR, to find the vector QR, it's very simple. You just plus vector QO plus with the vector OR to show that your vector are in a continuous form, guys. So these are the working for you to find the resultant vector. Vector QR is your resultant vector in this case. Okay, for that we need to prove that our vector PS is equals to vector QR. So how are we going to prove that? So we're going to add a coefficient over here. We're going to form a relationship such that PS equals to K QR. So this K value we have don't know yet. That's the value we're going to find out. So what we're going to do is we're going to substitute in the value of PS, vector PS, and value of vector QR over here. Okay, let us continue to the next step. Okay, so for vector PS is equals to negative 8P plus 3Q. Okay, equals to K in a bracket negative 32 over 3P plus 4Q. So what you're going to do now is we're going to expand in the K value inside. So from here you get negative 8P plus 3Q equals to negative 32 over 3K P plus 4K Q. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to compare the coefficient K in terms of component P and then in terms of component Q. And then we're going to check whether the K value gives the same answer or not. If the K value gives the same answer, that means we can denote that our vector PS is parallel to vector QR with a particular number relation. If they are not same, so we can conclude that our vector PS is not parallel to vector QR. Okay, let us proceed to the comparison. So we compare the component P and component Q respectively in between two vectors. Okay, so we start with the component P first. So negative 32 over 3K is equals to negative 8. So negative 32K is equals to negative 24. So from here, K is equals to 3 over 4. Okay, we get this 3 over 4 and then proceed with the vector Q. So 3 is equals to 4K. So we compare with the component Q over here. So 3 is equals to 4K. So we get K is equals to 3 over 4. Okay, we get the both of the values are the same. So from here, we can conclude that our PS is actually parallel to QR. Okay. So since P and Q give the same coefficient, so it is proven that PS is parallel to QR, which means vector PS is parallel to vector QR. with a relationship vector PS is equals to 3 over 4 out of vector QR. So this is your final answer, guys. Okay. Alright guys, that is all for my discussion and step-by-step working for this question. Any question or feedback, feel free to put in the comment section below. And before that, okay, how do you find this question? Is it easy or difficult? Could you manage to solve this question? Please put down in the comment section below. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell for more upcoming mathematics tutorial videos. Alright guys, thank you everyone for your support. And I will see you in the next video.